islands were first discovered by earliest European explorers, the first maps that were drawn of the island region, they named these islands Les Îles aux Serpentes, the Islands of Serpents. Coming into Lake Erie and they're looking at the shoreline, they were witnessing these massive amounts of water snakes basking along the shore. The Lake Erie water snake is a subspecies of the northern water snake, and they're only found on the islands within the western basin of Lake Erie. The water snake was listed as a federally threatened state endangered species. At the time of listing, it was low population size. It was estimated there's only 1,500 to 2,000 left on the U.S. islands. People were coming into contact with these water snakes fairly frequently, and they were going out of their way to actually kill the animals and try to eradicate the population. The Nerodio is our nickname for our annual Lake Erie Watersnake Census. The most significant and the most impressive thing about Nerodio is the number of animals that we see within a short period of time. For most snake biologists that are doing any kind of mark recapture or population studies, it's not uncommon for the number of animals that they're seeing within a year to be what we see in an afternoon. That's usually the comment that I get most often, that I have never in my life seen so many snakes in such a short period of time. Ohio Sea Grant and Stone Lab are still a huge partner within the conservation program of the water snake because they really provide a home base for all of our research and education and outreach efforts to really happen from. And because Sea Grant's three primary objectives are research, education, and outreach, it completely makes sense to have our conservation program be a part of what we do here. When the water snake was removed from the list of federally threatened and endangered animals in fall of 2011, it was the 23rd species to ever be removed from the list. I still pinch myself thinking about it, is because most researchers are not afforded the amazing opportunity to watch it go from being put on the endangered species list and then being able to see that through to where you can actually show with your data that these populations are stable and they're healthy and that they have made a comeback. Initially, the goals of Nerodio were just catch as many snakes as we can in a short period of time. But over the years, it's become not just a data collection endeavor, but also an outreach endeavor. We are constantly running into people that see us catching snakes, and it provides this opportunity then to talk about what we're doing, why we're doing it, and why it's important. I love this because there was this real need to provide this gap that I could have the best scientific data in the world when it came to their movements and activity patterns. But if I left and that person, that homeowner, didn't understand why it was important to leave the snakes alone, it wouldn't matter. And that, to me, that's doing conservation.